Mẹ quay bộ bài hay quá. Thank you, Rabia, for the quay bộ. I am young. Không đang nghĩ rằng không phải là ý gì. Okay. I'm sorry I'm gonna eat while talking to you guys, but first of all, welcome to my channel. This time around, it will not be a recipe video, but it'll be a video about how I started Home Sweet Oven, about myself. If you're expecting a recipe, it will be next week, next Sunday. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't. I just started doing setting up my YouTube channel after so long. My name is Shika. Some of my close friends or friends call me Shiks. Hold on a second, let me address something. I'm 28 years old this year. I do feel old, but it's life. I'm married. I have two kids. One girl and one boy. So the girl is turning 4 years old soon. The boy is 1.5 years old. No number three. No. Mm-mm. I started Home Sweet Oven actually right after I got married. Back in 2014. So, at that point of time, I was still having my full-time job, but I was searching for something else, something that I want to do for myself. So I tried doing online business selling macarons. So why macarons? So I've been exposed to baking by my mom. I always like help her out in the kitchen and bake with her. When I started out this online business, it grew into passion because I kind of like enjoy it, even though it's tiring, because I'm a one-man show. So even though it's tiring, but I like it. Why macarons? Because I didn't know it was a trend at that point of time, or it wasn't a trend yet, I'm not sure, back in 2014. But I look at the ingredients and I find it that it's simple, 4 main ingredients, and there's no dealing with butter or oily stuff, so it's not troublesome, you know, after washing up. Nevertheless, I realized that it was difficult at first. I failed a lot of times. I don't know how many batches that I threw away. At that point of time, I was still living with my mom. I don't know how many batches I really threw away, but it was so damn hard that I did not know why. It cracked, it was flat, it was lopsided, it wasn't the kind of fit that I want. I went for a class. I learned the French meringue method, and I think they're still around. It's by the Baking Calf at Yishun, I still remember, and it was 8 of us, and I learned the technique, and it was so helpful that I went back home, I researched again for another recipe, and I happened to chance upon Italian meringue. So I decided to give it a try, even though it was troublesome to like cook the sugar first before you add to your egg whites. So I did that, and I applied the technique that I learned during the class. And if you are watching this, do go for a class. Watching videos on YouTube is different compared to going for a class. It's more, you gain more knowledge. I started posting my photos on, my macaron photos on Instagram. That was the only medium that I used to sell them. And first it was only to like friends and family, and then it was word of mouth really helps a lot when people do recommend your stuff and do give positive feedback. And it did help a lot with word of mouth, and and then the followers grew, and then it kind of snowballed into doing personal orders, and then birthdays, engagements, and then for weddings. I still remember for the wedding part, like I wanted to sponsor my macarons for a friend, and for some reason I could not able to do it at the last minute. And no, as in she has a wedding cake already, just that I wanted to give her an additional macaron tower, but I could not do it. I can't remember why, but I already did the macarons. It's just that I couldn't set it up for her for a wedding. But I took the picture of that tower, and orders started coming in, and inquiries started coming in asking me about the macaron tower. So that's how I started to do for weddings. And it's not easy at first. I started doing full time since 2018. So before that, it was like on off, because I was still staying with my mom. So I had no place to bake. It was a hassle. And right now, I'm still pursuing my studies in pastry and baking. But at the same time, I'm still accepting orders, doing it all by myself, and juggle them, and doing classes, teaching people how to bake macarons, and at the same time I'm handling my social media, like online for my business, and doing YouTube also. So I was studying mass comm initially before I venture out into baking. So I had knowledge on doing videos, photography, journalism. So I used to love writing so much when I was young, but I kind of lost touch. That's how Home Sweet Haven started, and it has been 5 years or so, and I really love baking. And when I decided to pursue my studies in pastry and baking, it was something that I should have done long time ago, after I graduated or after I got married. I decided to just go for it. It's something that's helpful for me. I can learn a lot more rather than just baking macarons alone. I'll be graduating soon, next year. So a few more months to go. It's the last lap, but I can't wait to get that set. Hopefully in the future I will have my own baking studio. Right now I'm currently in my baking room in my house. It's small, but it's where I bake and film my videos. But hopefully in the future I'll get to expand, and I would like to go down the route of teaching people, holding more classes. Besides doing macaron classes. If you're watching this, thank you so much for sticking around, and I do hope that you'll support my channel and my upcoming videos, and do subscribe. And there'll be an upcoming class, macarons hands-on class, on the 5th of April at Icon at Changi. So if you are interested, do leave a comment, or do email us, or do DM us on Instagram, Home Sweet Haven, or on our Facebook page, Home Sweet Haven SG. Thank you for watching this video. I'm sorry if it bores you to death. For those of you who haven't seen my face yet, this is the face. I'm the owner behind Home Sweet Haven, and thank you so much for your support to my new customers, to my regular customers, to my friends, to my family. And yeah, so I'll see you around next Sunday. Bye.